You might saw the thumbnail from this video and thought, hell yeah, that looks great. But at the end of the video, you realized, yeah, this does not look like the thumbnail. And you're absolutely right. Fortunately, no one ever complained. But now, it's my time to reward your patience and to reveal the secret. I will show you some great ways to improve the look and feel of your 2D game with Unity's 2D lighting features, coming with the Universal Render Pipeline. And for this, I am going to recreate the light scene of my thumbnail. And later, I show you some other examples as well. This is a mostly accurate recreation of the tilemap from the thumbnail. There are two tilemaps, one for the whole crowd and another on top for the objects. I also added the sign that is definitely not a boat. I started by creating a new default 2D project, because I assume you already have an existing project. If you want to start new, you can skip the upcoming step and just create a new 2D URP project, because this is what we need. Unity's Universal Render Pipeline offers amazing 2D lightings that we will use to add the needed flair to display an old map. Let's install the package. Go to Window, Package Manager, select Unity Registry and look for Universal RP and install it. Great, now we need to configure it. I'll add those in a new folder called URP. Now right click, create, and at the bottom you should find rendering. We need two things, a 2D renderer and an according URP asset. Just click at the second one and both will be created. You can leave the default settings as they are working fine. We now have this 2D renderer data and the URP asset using this renderer. Now we just need to set it. Go to Edit, Project Settings and Graphics. This slot here is where we select the render pipeline we want to use. Currently it's the default built-in one. Just select your newly created URP asset file. One thing to mention. You saw that the fields below changed, like the sorting order, which is quite an interesting feature for 2D games. Let's say you watch a tutorial telling you to change the setting, and you want to, but no setting. Take a look in the 2D renderer data. There it is. And then you can change it, you know, like setting a custom axis because this is a top-down game. And now, this is applied and works. Kind of. One note. I am using the latest stable release right now. Unity 2021.2.12, which uses URP 12.1.4. Older Unity versions also use older versions of the URP package, so things might be a little bit different for you. I'll link the documentation of the package in the description. There you can select your URP or Unity version and take a look. Or you might want to look for URP tutorials for your version. This applies especially for Unity 2020 and older. Let's start by adding a global light. In your hierarchy, right-click Light, and at the bottom there now are all the 2D lights we can use. There is also the global light 2D. A light intensity of 1 is the default value, so basically how it was without those lighting features. But changing the value doesn't affect anything. Shouldn't it be pitch black with zero light? Yes. Unity has different renderer components. A sprite has a sprite renderer, a tilemap has a tilemap renderer. Everywhere we will find those materials here. The sprite's default material is not affected by the URP package, so it ignores the light. When starting with the 2D URP project, this looks different. There is another material. This material uses a light affecting shader. We could create this manually, but we can also automatically convert all materials to use the new shader. But be aware that this is a non-revertible process, so you might want to backup your project. Go to Window, Rendering, Render Pipeline Converter. Here we will leave the Convert Built-in to 2D setting. Click the Material Upgrade checkbox and click Initialize Converters. Then you should see some materials, Based on the size of your project, this might be more than for me. Then just hit Convert Assets and it's done. Now, for every existing tilemap, as well as every new one, there is this new material selected. This also applies to other assets. They all are now affected by light. All those steps, from installing, oversetting, to converting, is already done for you when using the 2D URP template. But now your existing project is also capable of everything. For everyone jumping to this point because they are using the 2D URP template, I added a global light to my scene. You should already have this, so let's start here. An intensity of 1 is default. Everything above makes the scene too bright, and since we want to add some more lights, let's reduce this value to something like 0.8. Now I want to simulate something like sunlight. In theory, the global light is of course the sunlight, because it affects everything. But sometimes it makes sense to highlight parts of your maps, especially in terms of user interaction. For this, I add a spotlight 2D. You can now either change the sizes directly in your scene, or via the inspector. Now I can move the light to where I want the main focus to be. Somewhere around here where the player might could interact with something. A spotlight has an outer and an inner radius. The closer the inner one is to the outer one, the sharper the edge. Of course, I want a soft edge. Feel free to play with all the settings, that's better for learning than me talking about everything. But the fully lighted parts are a bit too bright now, so I reduce the intensity of the spotlight a bit, so that it looks good. We could also give it a little bit of a tint. Based on the color, this changes the harmony of the image. I want a warm, yellowish color. Now, I am sure you are interested in the god rays. They really are beautiful. The foundation for this are simple PNG images like those here. Those here. Like these. You can create them on your own in any photo editing software. But you can also download the ones I made, the link is in the description, for free. If you want to create them on your own, all you need to do is to draw white lines with a relative soft border on a transparent background. Or you apply a blur filter on a harder edged line. Draw them horizontally, so you can easily cut the one image into those parts and then use them as you want. Then save it as PNG with a transparent background, or just download mine. Yeah. Import them into your Unity project. Set the sprite as multiple, and then just slice your rays. Be careful with the edges, especially for the softer ones. Now we want a new light, a sprite light. With this light you could use any sprite you want and make it shine or glow in its shape. Now we can just drag and drop one of our rays in here. Then you can adjust, rotate and scale your light like you want. Of course, scaling will affect the softness of your borders. That's why I use smaller rays instead of scaling a bigger one down. And if you set the normal maps here to fast, you will get a softer edge. If you know about normal maps, they give an option to dynamically light 2D sprites, so that they look like 3D. We have no normal map here, but what it does in this case is making softer edges along the center point. So change the distance like you want. Just make sure that your center point is not somewhere in the middle of the screen. That would maybe be a little bit unrealistic. Every light can be restricted in terms of what it will affect. This is done by those target layer settings here. Every renderer has a defined sorting layer, which is default as default. To add a new one, just click here. Be aware that I am talking about sorting layers, not layers. So changing this value also might affect the sorting of your sprites. Now my environment is on another sorting layer, and all my lights only affect the default layer. That's why they are black. Now I could add a new global light. This results in a warning log. You are only allowed to have one global light per layer. Changing my layer settings here to the test layer and removing the default one, I can now only affect this tilemap. But I don't need it, so I'll revert this. But this might be especially useful for your player. And basically, this is how I made the thumbnail. Just experiment with the different lights and settings, and you can achieve great results. In my game jam game Through the Dark, I experimented with a lot of lights. For example, those lanterns are checkpoints. When activated, the light component gets enabled and the lantern appears lighted. Those crystals, as well as these mushrooms, all have their own simple light, which shines in either blue or green. The crystals are blue, but instead of using a white light, using the same color for the light improves the shine effect much more. And you can also use your own custom code logic to change all the light settings. So you could make a multicolored lamp, or simulate a fire or flame by changing the intensity and the offset slightly and irregularly. I only showed you the important and most effective settings of these light features. But of course, there is so much more, just give it a try. Thank you for watching, and also thank you to everyone supporting me and the channel. Special thanks to my supporters on Patreon, Patrick, Naxwomo, Fashion Librarian and Ellie. Thank you all. And as usual, if you enjoyed the content, consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you next time.